Our next topic is this in fuzzy quantities, how to calculate the uncertainty of an operator, uncertainty of a physical quantity, or we can say how to calculate the fuzziness of a physical quantity. We can use different terms, fuzziness of the quantity or spread of the quantity or a measure of the error of the quantity. Okay. So let us see how we can calculate this. So what is the idea of fuzziness or uncertainty or spread of a physical quantity? We know that if we try to measure a physical quantity in a state of a system, and suppose this state is not an eigenstate of the corresponding operator, okay? Physical quantity, there is an operator corresponding to that physical quantity, and suppose our state of the system is not an eigenstate of this operator. In other words, we call it a general state of the operator. Then we know that in each trial of the measurement, we get a different eigenvalue in general. Okay, some of the trials may give repeated values, but in general, each trial can give different eigenvalues. Then we can find the average of all these trials, which we call expectation value. Okay, we can calculate the deviation. So we have a data set here, okay, with the different values. We know the average of this data set. Then we can calculate what is the measure of the spread of this data from the average value. Okay, each value may have some deviation from the average value. What is the measure of this deviation? Okay, this deviation we call, or this measure of this spread we call uncertainty in quantum mechanics. And there is a different way, there are different ways to measure this error or spread or uncertainty or fuzziness of the quantity. And one common way is to calculate the standard deviation. Okay, so what we are going to do is, let us take a data set. We will go back to the previous example, the example we have discussed in one of our previous classes of marks of 10 students in a class on a test paper. Okay, so we will take that data set and we will calculate, we will see how we can calculate the standard deviation. So this is our data set. We have a class of 10 students. And these are the results of the marks of a test done on this class. Three students have obtained 9 marks. X represents the marks in the test. So three students have got 9 marks. Two students have got 12 marks. Four have got 15 marks. And one student has got 19 marks. Okay. So the total number of students is summation over I. Ni is equal to 10. Okay. We have already done the average value of this data set. Let us repeat that calculation. So average value of x is, we know how it can be done now, summation over I, pi, xi. Okay, where pi is the probability to get a particular mark, xi. Okay, so how do we do this? What is the probability of getting 9 marks? Out of 10 students, 3 students are getting 9 marks. So what is the probability of getting 9 marks? 3 out of 10. So 3 by 10 into 9. Okay. Next marks. 2 students out of 10 has got 12 marks. 4 out of 10 have got 15 marks. So it is 4 by 10 the probability. And the probability of getting 19 marks is 1 by 10. Okay, so if you do all these calculations, we can get 30. Okay, so the mean value of this data set is 30. Okay, so now the point is, what is the point that I have stated earlier is that the average of this data set is 13. So now each data point, each the mark of each student deviates from this average value. So what is the measure of the spread of this deviation? That's what we want to calculate, and we calculate the standard deviation. Let us see how we can calculate the standard deviation. So first I am going to calculating the deviation of each data point from the average value. So let me use this symbol x minus x average. Okay, this angular bracket represents the average value of the quantity. So what is the deviation of each mark from the average value? Average mark is 13. Okay, so 9 minus 13, which is minus 4. You have to keep the sign also. 12 minus 13 minus 1, 15 minus 13 plus 2, and 19 minus 13 plus 6. This is the deviation. Now let us calculate the mean deviation. Okay, the average of these deviations. Let us say if we calculate, let us try to see if we take the mean of this deviation, can we get the spread? Let us see. So the mean of this deviation, I can use this symbol, right? X minus x average is the deviation, so mean of that deviation. Okay, so this is how do we calculate this? This is equal to summation over I pi x minus x average, correct? How do we calculate the mean of any quantity? Take the quantity and multiply with the corresponding probability. I have to use this symbol xi minus x average. So take the deviation of each data point from the mean and take the probability of that data point. Then let us do this calculation, summation over I pi into that. Okay, that deviation. So this is equal to so first case, what is the probability of this one? Again, 3 by 10. 3 out of 10 has got this much deviation. So 3 by 10 into minus 4, right? Next deviation is minus 1. The probability is 2 out of 10. So 2 by 10 into minus 1 plus 4 by 10 into, what is it? Plus 2. Plus 1 by 10 into 6. We can take 1 by 10 outside from here. So what you get is 3 into minus 4, minus 12, minus 2. Okay, so we have minus 14. Then this is 8. Okay, so minus 14 plus 8 is minus 6. Then here we have plus 6. Minus 6 and plus 6 will be 0. Okay, so the answer is 0. So the mean value of the deviations is 0. This is not an accidental result. This is true for any data set. Always the mean value of the deviation, average of all the deviations, will be 0. The reason is that 13 is the average, or so we have some, suppose we have some mean value, then half of the data set will be below that, half of the data set will be above that. Okay, mean will always be 0. Okay, not the sum, but not the sum of all these deviations, but the mean value of the deviations will always be 0. We can prove this easily. Take this initial expression x minus x average, the whole average. Take the average of this one. Okay, take the angular brackets for each one. So this is, if we expand this, we have to take the average value of x, right? Then average of average value. But average of average value is the same value. Okay, once we have got the average as 13, we cannot again take the average. If you again take the average, the value is again 13. So x average minus x average we get. The answer is 0. Okay, so the point is that if we take the deviations and simply take the average to get a measure of the spread, we will get 0. So somehow, but we know that 0 is not a measure of the spread, because we know that there is a spread. Each data point, each mark deviates from the average value. So we need some other way to calculate the spread. So what we can do is, the reason for getting 0 mean deviation as 0 is, some of the values are negative. Okay, so what we can do is, let us take the square of these deviations. Okay, so let us find the square deviations. So the square deviations are x minus x average square. Okay, so they take the square of each one. Minus 4 square is 16, minus 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 6 square is 36. So these are the square deviations. Now let us take the mean of these square deviations. It's called mean square deviation. Okay, so we are calculating mean square deviations or mean square deviation. So this mean square deviation, we can use the symbol mean of square deviations, that is mean of x minus x average square. This is mean square deviation. See, mean of average of the square of each deviation. Okay, so this is again summation over I pi xi minus x average square. Take each square deviation, multiply with the corresponding probability and take the sum. So what is the probability for this one? 3 by 10. Probability for this one, 2 by 10, etc. So if you do this calculation, what you get is 10.2. you can do this calculation. So the mean square deviation is 10.2. But is it a measure of the spread of these data points? No, because we have taken a square. We have taken the square of the deviations and taken the mean. Now we have to, the dimension is now different. We have taken a square. Now we have to get back to the spread. This is actually the square of the spread. Okay, so we have to get back to the spread, we have to take the square root. Okay. So the square root of mean square deviation is called a root mean square deviation. Root mean square deviation. Or RMS deviation for short. RMS, root mean square. This is also called standard deviation. So we use the symbol sigma for that. Okay, so the standard deviation is this is square root of mean square deviation, right? So mean square deviation is this one, mean of square root of the mean of square deviations. Okay, so this is in this particular data set, square root of 10.2, and the value is 3.194. So this root mean square deviation or standard deviation is a measure of the spread of this data set from the mean value. Okay, and this quantity, the standard deviation of a physical quantity in a quantum system, we call uncertainty of the quantity or uncertainty of the operator, because every physical quantity is represented by the operator. So the standard deviation of the operator is called uncertainty of the operator. So we are, before going on to a general statement of this, or before going on to the expression for the uncertainty of different operators, let us pause here and look at an easier way to calculate the standard deviation. Let us come back to this expression, mean square deviation. Okay. So there is another way to calculate this mean square deviation. Standard deviation is, after all, square root of the mean square deviation. So let us see. Come back to this expression. So mean of square deviations, right? Mean of square deviations. Now let me expand this the square expression for the square deviation. So mean of, let us expand this, x minus x average whole square. So what do you get? X square minus 2x x average plus x average square, correct? X square minus 2x into x average plus x average square, a minus b whole square. Okay, now let us take so we have to take the mean of three terms, x square 2x minus of 2x x average plus x average square. So take the mean of each term. So if you look at the first term, it is x square. So mean of x square. So x square average minus 2. If you look at this product, we need to take the average of only this one, because this is already an average value. So what you get is 2 into x average into this x average. Okay, we have taken the average of this one, this x, and there is no need to repeat the average. And if you come here, already it is x average square. There is no more, we don't have to take again an average. So this is same, x average square. Okay, so what you have is x square average minus 2. You have an x average into x average here, so you have an x average square plus another x average square. So the minus 2 x average square and this x average square will cancel. We get x square average minus x average square. For any data set, these two quantities are in general different. If they are same, then there is no standard deviation, there is no spread. Okay, but in general, this x square average, okay, average of x square and x average square, square of x average will be different. You can try this with any data set. Okay, so this is another way to calculate the mean square deviation. Okay, then the square root of that one will be standard deviation. This is actually easier. Okay, so this will be one step less than what we have calculated this. How we have calculated this. Okay, let's see that. So for this data set, let us try this expression and let us see if we can get the same value, same mean square deviation. Okay, so what you need here is x average square. Already we know that x average is 13. So what is x average square? 169. So what you need is x square average. Okay, so take each data set, each mark, find the square, and then take the average. So let us we need a set called x square. Okay, so square of each data point, square of 9, 81, 12, 144, 15, square is 225, 19, square is 361. So these are x square values. Now let's find x square average. Okay, so x square average, how do we calculate this? Summation over I, pi into xi square. Take each square value, multiply it with the probability. What is the probability for this x1 square or this xi square? 3 out of 10, 3 by 10 into 81. Similarly, 2 by 10 into 144, like that. Okay, so if you do this, we get 179.2 x square average for this data set. You can try this calculation. So what is x square average minus x average square? Okay, this is 179.2 minus x average square. X average is 13, square is 169. Okay, what is this? 10.2. Same as this one. So if you use this expression, okay, this expression or this expression, you will get the same value. And again, root mean square deviation of standard deviation is square root of this one. You can either take square root of this one or square root of this one. Okay, but this method is easier in the sense that in order to get this, what you have to do, you have to find the deviation and then take the square. then take the average, right, mean square deviation. But in order to get this, get the mean square deviation through this way, what you have, what you need is, once you have this one, this much one, you don't need these two steps. You need only a single step. Take x square. Take the average value of this one, x average square, and take x square and find the x square average. So instead of two steps, finding the deviation and taking the square, we need only to take the square of the data set. Okay. So this is, instead of two steps, we need only one step. Take x square, that's all. So this is easier. So this expression for standard deviation or mean square deviation, we can have these two expressions, but normally the easier one we can follow, that is standard deviation sigma is either square root of mean of square deviations x minus x average square. This is the standard, the definition, basic definition of standard deviation or root mean square deviation, square root of the mean of square deviations. But the same thing you can write as, the square deviations you can rewrite as x square average minus x average square. Okay, so this quantity, standard deviation or root mean square deviation, is taken as a measure of the spread of the physical quantity from the average value. And in quantum mechanics, when we take any physical quantity, we have a corresponding operator. The spread or error or measure of the spread or measure of the error, or we can say measure of the fuzziness of this operator, is called uncertainty of the operator. Okay. So this is how we define the uncertainty of any physical quantity. So let us try to write down the expression for uncertainty of different operators. Uncertainty of position operator. Remember that we calculate this uncertainty in a particular state of the system with reference to some wave function. Okay, so uncertainty in position operator, we use the symbol delta x for that. Okay, so this is actually this is nothing but the standard deviation in x. Okay, so this is what, square root of, if we use our second expression, x square average minus x average square. How do we calculate these values? What is x average? It is nothing but the expression for the expectation value of x in a particular state psi, in a particular state represented by the wave function psi. Similarly, what is x square average? You the same expression for expectation value. Instead of x, we have x square. That's all. Expectation value of x square. So find the expectation value of x square, find the expectation value of x, and then take the square. Okay? Take the difference and take the square root. That is the standard deviation in x. In other words, it's called uncertainty in position operator. Similarly, uncertainty of momentum operator. Let us use the symbol delta p. I have to actually use delta px if you are calculating x component of momentum, but I am dropping that suffix. Let us assume that we are considering one dimensional situation. So sigma p, standard deviation in momentum operator. How do we do this? Square root of p square average minus p average square. What is this? Expectation value of momentum operator. Okay, we know how to calculate the expectation value of any operator. Integral psi star operator psi. Okay, instead of that operator in the center, in between psi star and psi, we substitute momentum operator. What is the expression for momentum operator in one dimension? Minus I h cross dou by dou x, that we substitute there. Okay, and if we calculate the expectation value of momentum operator there, take the square also, to get p square average, p average square. Then how do we calculate p square average? In the same way, integral psi star p square operator psi. What is p square operator? Minus h cross square dou square by dou x square. You can go back and refer the table of operators that we wrote down. We wrote down the expression for kinetic energy operator, which is minus h cross square by 2m dou square by dou x square. So that is basically p square by 2m. So if you remove that 2m, we will get p square operator. So find the expectation value of p square operator, take the difference and take the square root. That is the uncertainty in momentum operator. When we do different applications, okay, different systems in one dimension, three dimension, etc., we will actually do this calculation. Okay, we need a wave function, a specific wave function for doing this calculation. So once we have a particular wave function for a state, then we can do this calculation. We can find the uncertainty in position operator. We can find the uncertainty in momentum operator. We can find the uncertainty relationship between them in that particular state. Okay. Delta x into delta p we can calculate. All these calculations we will do in particular examples when we do the different applications. Okay, so in general, what we can do, uncertainty of any operator delta A or standard deviation of that operator is square root of A square average minus A average square, where this A average is, I have to actually use the symbol for this operator, okay, integral psi star A psi. In one dimensional case it is dx, three dimensional case it is volume integral. Okay, so in general it is volume integral divided by psi star psi d. If it is a normalized wave function, denominator is 1, we know that. And similarly, what is A square average? A square average, expectation value of A square. A square. Okay, so this is very easy. Once we have a wave function of a particular state, find the expectation value of the operator A, and then we have to take the square to get this A square, A average square. And now to get the first part, find the expectation value of A square. Okay, so this is very easy. Once we have the wave function, we can calculate expectation value of A and take the square to get this. We can find the expectation value of A square. And from this we can calculate the uncertainty in that operator. This is how we do the uncertainty in how we calculate the uncertainty in position operator, how we calculate the uncertainty in momentum operator. So this can be easily done in once we have the wave function. Okay, so in conclusion, whenever we measure a physical quantity in a state, which is a general state for the corresponding operator. When I say general state, what I mean is which is not, this state is not an eigenstate of the corresponding operator, then each trial will have different, will give you different eigenvalues of the operator. So we can find the expectation value of the operator, average of all these trials. Then we can also calculate how each trial value, okay, or each eigenvalue deviates or differs from the expectation value. This is a spread of the deviations, or we can say spread of the error, okay, and this spread we call the fuzziness of that physical quantity or the uncertainty of the physical quantity or the measure of some error of that physical quantity. And the usually what we do in quantum mechanics is we quantify this spread or fuzziness or error as standard deviation. Okay, and this is the way to calculate the standard deviation of any operator. And then this happens on when the operator is in a general state. When we measure the physical quantity in the general state of the operator, or not the eigenstate of the operator. What happens when the state is the eigenstate of the operator? Then we know that each trial gives the same eigenvalue. If each trial gives the same eigenvalue, expectation value is the same eigenvalue. Okay, then each trial value is same as the average value. There is no spread. There is no uncertainty. Okay, there is no fuzziness. That's why we call that we say that the quantity is sharp in its own eigenstate. Sharp, there is no spread, there is no dispersion. Okay, if it is the state is not an eigenstate, then there is the quantity is dispersed. Okay, and the measure of dispersion, measure of fuzziness, is called uncertainty of the operator. As an example of calculating the uncertainty in position, let us do this problem. We have seen this system before, a few times before. Okay, so the same system, a particle limited to the x-axis has the wave function psi equal to ax between x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. Psi equal to 0 elsewhere, calculate the uncertainty in position of the particle, right? This system we have done before. The normalization of a constant of the particle, this wave function is root 3. So the normalized wave function is root 3x. Okay, we know how to do this. Yes, you can refer to one of the previous classes to see how we can normalize. So that's the first step. If we get a wave function, it's better to normalize it. Without normalization also, we can calculate expectation value of x and x square. But it's better. So once we normalize, we don't have to worry about the denominator part in the expectation values. That's the advantage. So this is a normalized wave function. And the expectation value of, next we need the expectation value of x. Okay. Expectation value of x also we have calculated in one of the in the previous classes. Its value is 0.75, 3 by 4 or 0.75. Remember how we calculate the uncertainty in position, square root of x square average minus x average square. So already we know x average. So I am not repeating this calculation again. You can do this. Let's see how do we calculate this part. So x square average is integral psi star x square psi dx. It's a one dimensional situation. That's why we are doing a one dimensional integral. Denominator is integral psi star psi dx. But for a normalized wave function, that part will be 1. Already we have normalized the wave function. Okay. So if you use this normalized wave function, the denominator is 1. So what are the limits? In general, minus infinity to plus infinity in one dimensional case. But here the wave function is non-zero only between x equal to 0 and 1. So we need to integrate from 0 to 1 only. So let us do this. So how do we calculate the expectation value of x in the same way? Except x, instead of x square, we need to use x. That's all. Okay. Since we have done this calculation in a previous class, I am not repeating. That's all. So let us do this. Integral 0 to 1. We have psi, what is psi star? Root 3x. It's a real wave function. So there is no complex conjugation. This is psi star. Then x square is there. What is psi? Again root 3x. Dx. So root 3 into root 3 is 3, which we can take outside. Integral 0 to 1. There is x here, x square here, another x here. So we have x raised to 4. Okay. So x square average is 3 into integral of x raised to 4 is x raised to 5 by 5. And we have to put the limiting values 0 and 1. And if we calculate that, we get 3 by 5, 3 into 1 by 5. 3 by 5 is 0.6. Okay, so x square average is 0.6 and x average is 0.75. Now we can calculate the uncertainty in position. Delta x is square root of x square average, which is 0.6 minus x average square, okay, square of 0.75. okay, square of 0.75, if you do this calculation, we get 0.5625. you have to take the square of this one. Okay, x average square, it's 0.5625, and if you subtract and take the square root, we get 0.194. this is the uncertainty in position of this particle. In other words, it's a measure of the spread or fuzziness of position of this particle. The reason is that this state is not an eigenstate of the position operator. Okay, so there is a spread when we measure the, actually experimentally measure the position of this particle using some 10 trials. In each trial we get different values. Okay, then you can take the average value, which is this. Then you can calculate the spread or fuzziness of position from the average value, and that is given by the standard deviation 0.194. So in this way, once we have a specific wave function, okay, in our case the wave function is this in this particular problem. If we have a particular wave function, we can normalize it. Once we have a normalized wave function, this is how we calculate the expectation value of position operator. The same way we can calculate the expectation value of momentum operator. Only thing is that here we need to substitute the proper expression for the corresponding operator. That's all. So how we can, this way we can calculate the uncertainty in any operator once a state is given. Thank you.